Okay, so in the early versions of the DWSIM, I was starting to learn VB.NET and learn how to make things. And initially, I had coded the DWSIM only in Portuguese, but then I started to think what I was doing, why doing another process simulator if the market was already full of process simulator, commercial process simulator, and what I was trying to do. So the first release of the DWSIM was not distributed to the public. I kept it for myself. Then one of the in a certain day I was navigating the internet and I found Google group about OpenSIM, which was the open source process simulator. Let me see if I can find it. It's here. Okay. This is the one. I started to read this message. Basically, they started to make an open source process simulator in Pascal, but they started to plan all things too much and actually didn't make too much also. And then everything started to run. And I was then I thought maybe I should release the WSIM for free. And a few days later, after letting the people know about the WSIM, I took the decision to make it open source because I thought that it could contribute a little more to the people, my colleagues and my fellow professionals, if they actually knew how a process simulator works. And since this OpenSIM project had failed at the time, I thought that maybe I could make my own contribution to the world and make my project open source. And there is a topic on this Google group about the WSIM where I let people know that the WSIM is open source. This is the one. I'll put this link on the resource for this course, so don't worry about remembering this link. Okay, so here in 2008, I've released the WSIM 1.3 under the GPLv3 license, which is the open source license. And I had to translate WSIM from Portuguese to English using Google Translator, and it was a little messy at the time, but it worked quite nicely. And the people went crazy when I released the WSIM because this was everything that they wanted to have, and I've appeared with everything done already. And I know I was very excited at the time because people went happy, and I was very happy, very, very happy to see that it was something that they wanted, and it was all that I wanted at the time too. You can see here some feedback from the guys, and this was how the WSIM became open source. And